Now the next topic is merchant discount rate. So if anyone has any query, please ask in the chat box, right? If anyone is having any query, ask in the chat box. And rest of the people, please solve this question. बाकी लोग जो हैं ये क्वेश्चन सॉल्व करेंगे, ठीक है? Ramashis, explain the previous question, sir. My friend, I have taken around 25 plus minutes, around 30 minutes to discuss the entire topic of RBI economic capital framework, right? So I will upload the recording of this session by tonight. And after that, you can watch the recording and you can listen to the discussion. If you listen to the discussion, after that, you can solve the question very, very easily. Okay. I will also upload the PPT on the Telegram channel. मैं PPT भी Telegram channel पे upload कर दूँगा. You can see the PPT on the Telegram channel and you can see the question also. ठीक है? We have to move forward. That is why I cannot show you right now. Supriya Bhange, sir, please display full screen of question. तो फुल स्क्रीन तो दिखाई रहा हूं मैं. कांट यू सी द फुल स्क्रीन? एवरीवन इज गिविंग द आंसर. कैन यू सी द फुल स्क्रीन? से यस इफ यू कैन सी द फुल स्क्रीन, बिकॉज आई कैन सी. मेनी ऑफ यू आर यूजिंग द मोबाइल फोन, राइट? आप लोग जब मोबाइल फोन यूज करोगे, यू शुड कीप योर मोबाइल फोन इन द हॉरिजॉन्टल मैनर. अगर आप इस तरह से, ये जो मोबाइल फोन है, अगर आप इस तरह से यूज करोगे तो आपको ये देख सकते हो आप. या अगर आप इस तरह से यूज करोगे तो आपको हाफ स्क्रीन दिखाई देगी, ठीक है ना? ये मैंने अपनी क्लास अपने मोबाइल पे खोली हुई है, सो दैट आई कैन चेक योर व्यू ऑल्सो. ठीक है? इफ यू सी, इफ यू कीप द मोबाइल वर्टिकली, देन दिस विल बी हाफ स्क्रीन. But if you do this mobile horizontal, then you can see the full screen. So keep your mobile horizontal, then you can see the full screen. ठीक है सुप्रिया? सुप्रिया please do this. रामाशीष को मिल गया है, ठीक है? So please do like that. So you will get the full screen. Everyone, please use your phone horizontally so that you can see the full screen. Sir, how can we access to the session which we missed? So my friend, I will soon upload all the sessions on the YouTube. The session number 1 and 2 are already there on the YouTube, so you can see them. Or rest of the session I will upload. I will make a playlist in the YouTube and I will post on the Telegram channel, right? I will do this work by tonight. मैं इस काम को आज रात तक कर दूंगा. So you have to wait till tonight. And you can see that playlist in the Telegram, in the Telegram group, right? So you can see all the previous lecture also. So coming to the merchant discount rate, merchant discount rate ki hum baat karte hain. What is merchant discount rate? Please solve one more question, then we will discuss. Theek hai? Okay, good. I can see a lot of answers. Very good. Please keep giving the answers. Answer dete raho. Surajit, where is your answer? Shubhajit, Sujana, Saurabh, if you don't know the answer, you can write an or no. Okay, कोई बात नहीं, नहीं पता है तो कोई बात नहीं, आप लोग यहां पढ़ने के लिए हो. How many of you cannot understand Hindi? कितने लोग ऐसे हैं जो हिंदी नहीं समझ सकते? ओके सौरभ, नेफी नेफी, व्हाट इज योर गुड नेम? नेफी नेफी, प्लीज गिव द आंसर. चलिए, सो लेट अस सी, लेट अस फर्स्ट डिस्कस दिस टॉपिक. Sir can't understand technical terms in Hindi. Okay, great. I will discuss everything in English. और कुछ कुछ चीजें मैं हिंदी में बोलता रहूंगा. I will speak few words in Hindi, but without missing anything in English. English में मैं सब कुछ पढ़ूंगा, बोलूंगा ही बोलूंगा. चलिए. So this is the mechanism of merchant discount rate. ठीक है, ये merchant discount rate का mechanism है. So just see, इसको देखो. Suppose this is a petrol pump. ये petrol pump है. And you want to, taken the 100 rupees petrol. आपने 100 rupees का petrol buy किया है. So you swipe your card for rupees 100. This is a bank. So your bank, your money goes to the bank. 100 rupees goes to the bank. जो भी आपने, आप क्या करते हो, ये जो कार्ड है, ये कार्ड स्वाइप करते हो. And this bank is there. Suppose this is the State Bank of India. So this State Bank of India receives 100 rupees. Now, out of this 100 rupees, it will cut rupees 1 for the, its service charge. जो भी इसका service charge है, उसके लिए 1 rupees ये cut कर लेता है पहले से. ये जो 1 रुपीज होता है, इसको बोलते हैं मर्चेंट डिस्काउंट रेट. दिस इज कॉल्ड मर्चेंट डिस्काउंट रेट, राइट? 99 रुपीज गोज टू द पेट्रोल पंप ओनर. जो 99 रुपीज है वो पेट्रोल पंप ओनर के पास चले जाते हैं. नाउ दिस 1 रुपी, दिस इज नॉट कैप्ड विद द एसबीआई इटसेल्फ. जो 1 रुपया है, दिस गोज टू द 3 डिफरेंट एजेंसीज. सो इन दिस होल प्रोसेस, इफ यू सी दिस प्रोसेस, if we see this process, in this whole process, 3 different agencies are involved. One is the card agency. ये जो card है, ये card हो सकता है रुपए का, और this card can be Mastro, right? और Visa. So there can be many companies which can be, issuing these kind of card. ये जो card है, ये बहुत सारी अलग अलग companies issue कर सकती हैं, ठीक है? So this card is issued by some company. Second, the payment, I gave the wrong example. Card issuing bank, bank जो card issue कर रहा है, ठीक है? So it can be, for example, PNB. ये PNB ने card issue किया. Payment network, Mastercard, Visa, Rupee, ठीक है? जिस कंपनी के नेटवर्क पे ये कार्ड काम करता है, ऑन हूज नेटवर्क दिस कार्ड वर्क्स. एंड थर्ड इज द बैंक व्हिच इज प्रोवाइडिंग द POS मशीन, फॉर एग्जांपल दिस SBI. सो SBI हैज प्रोवाइडेड दिस POS मशीन, राइट? सो दीज थ्री डिफरेंट बैंक्स, दीज थ्री डिफरेंट एजेंसीज, दीज थ्री डिफरेंट ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस आर शेयरिंग दिस मर्चेंट डिस्काउंट रेट, राइट? सो द बैंक merchant deal does not allow the retailer, the pump petrol pump owner, to pass on the MDR charge to the buyer. So jo ye 1 rupees ka kharcha hai, ye kiski jeb se kata? Ye petrol pump ki, jo petrol pump owner hai, uski jeb se paisa kata, right? right? So this money has been reduced from the pocket of petrol pump owner. This petrol pump owner cannot charge this money on the buyer. Petrol pump owner जो है ये 1 rupees आपसे नहीं ले सकता, ये उसको अपनी जेब से ही देना पड़ेगा. So there is a news, एक news है, and this is very very important. In 2019 budget, the merchant discount rate has been revoked for those establishments who are having the annual turnover of more than 50 crore rupees. So, jinka annual turnover 50 crore rupees se zyada hai. What is the meaning of turnover? Turnover basically means the total sales revenue. Jitna bhi unka sales ka revenue hai, usko hum bolte hain turnover. So, turnover does not mean profit. Turnover ka matlab profit nahi hota. Turnover ka matlab hota hai total sales amount. So, if the annual turnover of a business is 50 crore rupees or more, then they cannot charge. They cannot charge the merchant discount rate, right? On the customer or on them, on themselves. ठीक है? The purpose is to promote the digital payment and to promote the less cash money. ठीक है? तो कई केस में यहाँ पे हम क्यों कह रहे हैं कि वो कस्टमर पे इम्पोज नहीं कर सकता, क्योंकि कई केस में यहाँ पे तो हमने बोला कि पेट्रोल पंप ओनर वो पास ऑन नहीं करता, बट इन सम ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस दे कैन बी इन एग्रीमेंट, यहाँ पर जो एमडीआर है वो कस्टमर पर ट्रांसफर कर दिया जाता है, राइट? तो आप लोग भी जब शॉपिंग करने जाते होगे तो कई बार ऐसा होता होगा कि आप कार्ड से पेमेंट करना चाहते हो और जो सेलर है वो कहता है कि मैं कार्ड से पेमेंट नहीं लूंगा, अगर कार्ड से पेमेंट लूंगा तो मैं आपसे एक्स्ट्रा चार्ज करूंगा 2%, क्योंकि मेरा 2% जेब से पैसा जाता है. So at that time the merchant is charging the MDR from you, from the customer. So that is also not allowed after the budget 2019 if the annual turnover of any organization is more than 50 crore rupees, right? What is MDR? So MDR is, this is also called as the transaction discount rate. It is the sum of all the charges and taxes that a digital payment entails. डिजिटल पेमेंट पे जो भी चार्जेस और टैक्सेस लगते हैं, हमारे एग्जांपल में 1 rupees, उसको मर्चेंट डिस्काउंट रेट बोलते हैं. ये इंक्लूड करता है बैंक चार्जेस जो बैंक को पेमेंट होती हैं, ठीक है, और प्रोसेसिंग चार्ज जिसको पेमेंट एग्रीगेटर को और कार्ड इश्यूइंग कंपनी को इश्यू किया जाता है, ठीक है. नाउ चलिए, सो द आंसर टू द क्वेश्चन, क्वेश्चन नंबर 1, आंसर इज ऑप्शन सी. चार्ज टू ए मर्चेंट बाय द बैंक फॉर एक्सेप्टिंग पेमेंट फ्रॉम हिज कस्टमर थ्रू द बैंक्स डेबिट कार्ड. ठीक है, तो जो बैंक है वो मर्चेंट को चार्ज कर रहा है, ठीक है, जो पेमेंट वो अपने कस्टमर से रिसीव कर रहा है उसके लिए, ठीक है. सो दिस इज द फी लेविड बाय द बैंक from the merchant for providing them with the settlement infrastructure or POS machine. Zero MDR refers to the proposal made by center in the last budget to do away with all the charges on the digital payment transactions where the turnover is more than 50 crore rupees. Answer to this question is option 1 and 2 both, right? So this second amendment is as per the budget 2020. चलिए, नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज बिजनेस कोरेस्पोंडेंट्स. सो प्लीज टेक दिस क्वेश्चन. रामाशीष, थैंक यू वेरी मच फॉर द अप्रिसिएशन. साहित्य, टिल व्हेन एमडीआर इज रिवोक्ड? सो आर यू आस्किंग अबाउट द टाइमलाइन? इट इज रिवोक्ड फॉर एवर फॉर दोज कंपनीज विच आर बिग, दैट इज द टर्नओवर इज 50 crore और मोर. ठीक है, अगर 50 करोड़ या उससे ज्यादा का टर्नओवर है तो ये हमेशा के लिए रिवोक हो गया. ठीक है, तो आशीष, आर यू ऑन सम गवर्नमेंट ड्यूटी? मैंने आपका इमेज देखा था दैट यू आर वियरिंग द यूनिफॉर्म. ओके, कहां पर हो आप? बिकॉज दिस इज रियली वेरी डिफिकल्ट टाइम. द पीपल इन द यूनिफॉर्म दे आर कॉन्ट्रीब्यूटिंग सो मच. डीप रेस्पेक्ट. डॉक्टर्स और पुलिस दो ही लोग हैं जो जिन्होंने हमारे देश को बचा के रखा हुआ है. सो आई रियली सैल्यूट यू ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ माई फैमिली, ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ माई ऑर्गेनाइजेशन एंड ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ द होल स्टूडेंट कम्युनिटी हु आर प्रेजेंट हियर. आई रियली सैल्यूट यू. यू आर इन द फील्ड. आई नो इट इज नॉट ईजी. बाहर जाने में डर लगता है आज के समय में. इट इज वेरी वेरी डिफिकल्ट टास्क. आई रियली सैल्यूट योर वर्क, ईच वन ऑफ यू. ग्रेट. सो ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ ऑल द पीपल इन दिस क्लास, एक्सेप्ट आवर सैल्यूट, एक्सेप्ट आवर रिस्पेक्ट फॉर योर सेल्फ. थैंक यू वेरी मच फॉर डूइंग दिस वर्क, बींग ऑन द ग्राउंड, रिस्किंग योर लाइफ. आई नो इट इज नॉट वेरी इजी. डू वी हैव एनी अदर पर्सन लाइक डॉक्टर, पुलिस और सम कोरोना वॉरियर इन आवर क्लास एज ऑफ नाउ? Ashish is already there in the uniform, in the police. चलिए, great, thank you very much. चलिए तो ये question देखिए आप लोग. So this answer to this question is option A, one only, right? So in this case, NBFCs are not allowed. NBFCs are not allowed. Oh, Nafida, you are a nurse and you are in a corona ward duty. Oh, that's great. Thank you very much for serving us, for serving every human being, Nafida. So, what is your location, Nafida? Nafida, which city or which place? चलिए, सो लेट अस डिस्कस बैंकिंग कॉरेस्पॉन्डेंट्स. ठीक है, ओके. कन्नूर, केरला, दैट्स ग्रेट. केरला में तो लाइक देयर बीन रियली विन, दे हैव रियली वॉन दिस गेम ऑफ कोरोना. केरला हैज एमर्ज्ड सक्सेसफुल, दैट्स रियली ग्रेट. ग्रेट, थैंक यू वेरी मच फॉर कॉन्ट्रीब्यूटिंग टू द ह्यूमैनिटी, कॉन्ट्रीब्यूटिंग टू द ह्यूमन बींग्स, बींग देयर, रिस्किंग योर लाइफ. I know it is not easy. Thank you very much, Nafida. So, banking correspondents. So, what is the context of banking correspondents? What is the context of banking correspondents? So, basically, we have the banking infrastructure. These banks are available in urban areas, in rural areas. Now, the banks which are available in both the places, they may not be able to reach out their services to the remote villages. So even though banks are available in rural areas, but in the rural areas also, for a group of many villages, say 5 villages, 6 villages, 7 villages, there is a one bank. There is only one bank. So there are very various remote areas where the banks are not able to reach out, and the people, they want to have the banking services. Wo banking services lena chahte hain, theek hai? So here, what banks are doing? The banks are engaging business correspondents. Banking correspondents. They are engaging banking correspondents. Wo banking correspondents engage kar rahi hain, theek hai? Sorry, business correspondent only. So they are engaging the business correspondents. So they are involved into various work, the awareness about the savings, so that people can deposit their money. It will channelize into the savings of the economy, and it will also prove as a saving which can be used by the household, by the family, providing the transaction facility, transition in the form of deposit of amount. So please understand this very, very carefully. There can be a question, what can be the services offered by the bank, this business correspondent? Kya kya services business correspondent offer kar sakte? Give me a second. Okay, so they provide various kind of facilities like deposits, a small withdrawal of the amount, right? They are basically representing the branches in the remote areas. They are the agent of the branches. Wo branches ko represent karte hain, theek hai? They are helping the villagers in opening the account. So the villagers can give the papers to them and they can accept the papers. They can help them in opening the account. Please listen to this very, very carefully. Ye sare function ko aapko aaram se samajhna hai. You have to understand these terms, right? You have to keep in mind each and every point, because there can be a question in the exam where they can ask which of these services are not offered or which of these services are offered. So in that case, you should be able to know ki kon kon si services wo kar sakte hain, kon kon si services nahi kar sakte. Helping the self-help groups to get the loans, giving advance to villagers out how to invest everything, helping the bank to collect the EMIs. So loan recovery is also possible. So please take care of this. Loan recovery is also possible by the business correspondent, right? So this is also possible. Identification of borrowers and classification of activities as per the requirement. Enrollment of customers, including collection of biometric detail, providing the card. So they can evolve into all kind of activities. Why this term is in news? This is in news because of during this corona time, the bank business correspondent for banks, that is the self-help group women, BC Sakhis, they have been playing a vital role in the disbursement of first tranche of X ratio of 500 rupees to the women under the Pradhan Mantri Jan Dhan Yojana. So during the corona lockdown, rupees 500 rupees have been given to each of the PM Jan Dhan Yojana account holder who is a women beneficiary. So these BC Sakhis, they have provided this money to them. Theek hai? So this is the important role that they have played in the remote areas. That is why they are in news. So they are the retail agents which are engaged by the bank for providing the banking services at the locations other than the bank branch or ATM. तो कौन सी लोकेशन पर? दे विल बी वर्किंग इन दोज लोकेशंस वेयर वी डोंट हैव एनी बैंक ब्रांच और एटीएम, बिकॉज इन दोज लोकेशंस दे विल बी प्रोवाइडिंग द डोरस्टेप सर्विसेज. दे हैव द फुल रेस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी द बैंक्स. तो बैंक जो होती है द बैंक, तो बैंक इज हैविंग द फुल रेस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी फॉर एनी एरर acts of omission and commission of the BCs that they engage and have therefore to ensure through due diligence and additional safeguard for minimizing the agency risk. So if something happens, if something wrong happens by the business correspondent, it is the responsibility of the bank. So you can see this thing. Please read this very, very carefully. There is a possibility of question which can come from here. The question has already been asked in the past. पहले ऑलरेडी क्वेश्चन पूछा जा चुका है. नाउ दे कैन अगेन आस्क द क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम द सेम टॉपिक. ठीक है, सो प्लीज रीड दिस वेरी वेरी केयरफुली. आई एम गिविंग यू 1 मिनट. आपको मैं 1 मिनट दे रहा हूं. प्लीज रीड दिस वेरी वेरी केयरफुली. So they are permitted to perform various activities, identification of borrower, awareness, education advice, supporting the self-help group, recovery, collection of small value amount, recovery of principal interest, micro insurance, pension products, small value remittances. All these activities they can do. In the prelims examination, even a single point can be asked from this area. They can appoint the individuals who can be engaged as BCs. They can appoint the individuals from different areas, retired bank employee, etc. They can engage the NGOs or microfinance institutions which are registered under the Societies Act or Trust Act. They can engage cooperative societies, post offices, companies who are having the retail outlets. Okay, for example, Reliance Retail, right? But NBFCs cannot participate. Why NBFCs do not participate? Because they are also into the same business. So there will be a conflict. A conflict ho sakta hai. But after 2014, one category of NBFC has been allowed. That is NBFC who are not taking the deposit. non-deposit taking NBFC, they have been allowed, right? So in our question, the question which I gave to you, there is a small correction. NGOs, cooperative societies, post offices, and deposit taking NBFC. So deposit taking NBFC is not allowed. Therefore, this statement 2 is wrong. Now who will tell me? What is the difference between the bank and the NBFC? Right? So who will tell me what is the difference between the bank and the NBFC? I want to test your knowledge. Kaun batayega mujhe? You can write the main points. Yes, very good, Venkatesh. So the banks, they can accept demand deposit. What is the meaning of demand deposit? The deposit up to 12 month, maturity. NBFC cannot accept demand deposit. They can accept the term deposit. That means the deposit of 12 month or more. They can accept this deposit. Secondly, the banks. The banks are part of the payment and settlement system. What is the meaning of this? This means, suppose I am suppose you want to deposit the fees to me. You are having the account in the Punjab National Bank. आपके पास में पंजाब नेशनल बैंक में खाता है. You pay your, you give your check of PNB to me. I deposit the check in my own account. My account is in the State Bank of India. So the check which I have deposited in my SBI, my SBI will go to the payment and settlement mechanism and will recover the money from the PNB from that mechanism. So that transfer of money from your account in PNB to my account in SBI, it happens because of the payment and settlement mechanism. But in case of NBFC, they are not part of the payment and settlement mechanism. Therefore, the customers of the NBFC, they cannot issue the checks. They cannot issue the checks. Wo check issue nahi kar sakte. Theek hai? The customer of the NBFC, they cannot issue the checks. Wo check issue nahi kar sakte. Is that okay? Haan, yes. Then in case of bank, there is a insurance guarantee. कुछ डिपॉजिट इंश्योरेंस होता है वो बैंक वाले केस में होता है. बट इन केस ऑफ एनबीएफसी इट इज नॉट अवेलेबल. एंड देन देयर आर मेनी अदर स्मॉल स्मॉल डिफरेंसेस आल्सो. फॉर एग्जांपल दिस इज रेगुलेटेड बाय द बैंकिंग रेगुलेशन एक्ट. एनबीएफसी दे आर रेगुलेटेड बाय द आरबीआई बट दे आर नॉट पार्ट ऑफ द बैंकिंग रेगुलेशन एक्ट. राइट. बट देयर आर सम सिमिलैरिटीज. बोथ आर इन द बिजनेस ऑफ बैंकिंग लाइक एक्सेप्टेंस ऑफ मनी एंड giving the loan. And both are like, there are many NBFCs which are also regulated by the RBI. Banks are regulated only by the RBI. NBFCs can be regulated by the RBI, and then there are other agencies also, for example IRDA, SEBI, and National Housing Bank, who can regulate the NBFCs in their own sectors. Right. So in case of bank, there is only one regulator, that is RBI. But in case of NBFC, there can be multiple regulators. ठीक है, चलिए, great, very good. So you should also always think like that. Now next question is this RBI guideline with respect to the payment aggregators. Nowadays RBI guidelines are also becoming very very important. In 2018 and 2019, in both the years, the question have been asked about the RBI guideline. That is why we cannot skip RBI guideline. Please take 30 seconds. Give the answer in the chat box. Everyone, please give the answer. I need the answer from everyone. Agar aapko nahi aata, tab bhi koi problem nahi hai. Still, you can give the answer. Okay, good. I can see many answers. Divya, where is your answer? Nafida. Saurabh, I can't see your answer. Preet. Chaliye, very good. Wonderful. So the answer to this question is option A. इसका मतलब होता है option A. So let us understand the meaning of payment aggregator. ठीक है, तो आप लोगों ने ऑनलाइन पेमेंट की होगी, लोगों ने ऑनलाइन पेमेंट की होगी. सो मेनी ऑफ यू आर माई स्टूडेंट्स ऑल्सो इन वेरियस कोर्सेस. सो फॉर एग्जाम्पल यू गो टू द वेबसाइट, सपोज आप अमेजन पे कुछ बाय करते हो. ठीक है, आप अमेजन पे कुछ बाय करते हो. सो अमेजन इज ए बिजनेस वेबसाइट, यू आर द कस्टमर. फॉर एग्जाम्पल मिस्टर ए so the amazon will use the services of any payment aggregator. jo amazon hai wo kisi payment aggregator ki service use karega. it can be for example razorpay or for example in our case right to buy yes we are using the services of the instamojo. hum log instamojo ki services ko use karte hain, right? so we will deploy this instamojo, like amazon has deployed this instamojo on the amazon. when mr a wants to pay any amount, when he clicks on the payment button, the window will open where Instamojo will be accepting the payment. This Instamojo will be integrating various banks with itself. बहुत सारे बैंक हैं जहां पर आप पेमेंट कर सकते हो. सो Instamojo will accept the payment and it will pay the payment to the Amazon. ठीक है, so it is working as the payment aggregator, right? so they are the players who integrate with the e-commerce companies. That is the Amazon, जो e-commerce companies के साथ में इंटीग्रेट करते हैं, like for example Amazon and connect them with the banks. उनको बैंक के साथ में कनेक्ट करते हैं. ठीक है, तो Instamojo जो है, when Instamojo receives this amount, it will be depositing in the bank account of Amazon. जो bank account of Amazon है उसमें deposit कर देगा. They receive payment on behalf of these companies and transfer the money to their account. Example है BillDesk, CC Avenue, First Data, Razorpay, Cashfree, Paytm Payment Gateway. So whenever you pay any amount in the online transaction, that amount is collected with the help of the payment aggregator. So that is the meaning of payment aggregator. ठीक है? Now there are some guidelines about the payment aggregator. So what is happening is that anyone can open the website and anyone can start accepting the payment. तो आप भी अपनी वेबसाइट खोलो, इंस्टामोजो में अकाउंट खोलो और पेमेंट एक्सेप्ट करना शुरू कर दो. बट बिकॉज ऑफ दैट देयर वर वेरियस इलीगल एक्टिविटीज व्हिच स्टार्टेड हैपनिंग, सब प्रोहिबिटेड और फेक आइटम्स गेट स्टार्टेड सेलिंग. तो वो सब काम होने लगा, सब मनी लॉन्ड्रिंग स्टार्टेड हैपनिंग. व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ मनी लॉन्ड्रिंग? दैट मींस कन्वर्जन ऑफ ब्लैक मनी इनटू द व्हाइट मनी, एंड दैट कन्वर्जन हैपेंस थ्रू द क्रॉस बॉर्डर ट्रांजैक्शंस. That is the cross Indian's border. So money goes, the black money goes through hawala channel to the outside India, for example to the USA. India se USA mein ye paisa chala gaya through the hawala, and again USA, from the USA this money is being deposited with one of the payment aggregator in the form of some purchase transaction. So purchase transaction dikha karke हमने पेमेंट एग्रीगेटर से ये पेमेंट करके और फोर फिर हमने वापस ले ली, राइट? सो फॉर एग्जांपल मैं राइट टू बाय आईएएस हूं, आई एम द राइट टू बाय आईएएस, आई हैव सम ब्लैक मनी, राइट? सो मैं एग्जांपल दे रहा हूं, आई डोंट हैव एनी ब्लैक मनी फॉर द सेक ऑफ योर क्लैरिटी. सपोज आई हैव द ब्लैक मनी, आई ट्रांसफर दिस ब्लैक मनी टू वन ऑफ अकाउंट ऑफ माई ब्रदर हु इज लिविंग इन यूएसए. तो यूएसए में जो मेरा भाई रहता है उसके अकाउंट में मैंने ट्रांसफर कर दिया. Now he will come to my right to buy yes website, he will buy my course from his account, and the money will come to the Instamojo, and Instamojo will give the money to me. Instamojo वैसे मुझे दे देगा. So black money which I had in India, I have converted that money to the white money with the help of money laundering. Is that clear to everyone? कि मैंने कैसे अपना black को white में convert किया? So the money which I had in the black money in India, I converted that into the white money by transferring the money to the USA and getting back that money through the payment aggregator. So to avoid this kind of transaction, these payment aggregators, they have been instructed by the RBI to take care of the KYC norm, that they should know who is their customer. They should verify whether the business is actually right or wrong. So business, the business is not a fraud, right? And business is not being used to convert the black money into the white money. So to check on their merchant customer that they are not involved into any kind of prohibited or fake item, they have to set up designated nodal offices to deal with the customer grievances also. If suppose you pay some amount to the Amazon and Amazon do not give you some service, so you can go to the payment aggregator that I have deposited the money with the you on behalf of the Amazon and Amazon has not delivered the service to me. So in that case, the InstaMojo or the payment aggregator, they will support you, right? And RBI has also prohibited payment aggregator from allowing online transactions to be done with the ATM pin. ATM pin se aap nahi kar sakte. You have to use the card, different card or maybe OTP. Ya to aap OTP use karo ya card ek kuch aur third part third kind of aap code use karo. ATM pin cannot be allowed because they can be leakage of the ATM pin for withdrawing the cash from the account of the customer. So ATM pin has been disallowed in the online transactions of payment aggregators. Okay. So answer to this question is option A. They are the players who integrate with the e-commerce companies and connect them with the bank. Jo bank ke sath mein unko connect karte hain. Theek hai. Okay, great. So now the time for the homework. Abhi time ho gaya homework ke liye. So I have discussed many concepts. Rest of the concept I will discuss tomorrow. Now it is the time for the homework. So how many of you have done the homework? How many of you don't know what is the homework? Kitne logo ko pata hi nahi hai ki homework kya hai?